Gurdeep, I'm going to get into the debt reduction bit in just a bit, but I want to ask you specifically about the plan for two specific transactions. One is the SLD. So when exactly will the demerger of the wireless business be completed and the subsequent merger with SL go through? Give me a specific timeline that you're aiming.
Let me first comment about our quarterly results. During the last quarter, the sector's operational and financial performance has been continuing severe adverse impact due to free offers, disruptive pricing, and hyper-competition. For the first time in over 20 years, the sector has registered degrowth in revenues, leading to a reduction in the government share in revenue, sharp drop in operating margins, accompanied by increased interest costs arising from a staggering industry debt burden. And higher depreciation and amortization charges as a result of higher spectrum purchase costs. Steep declines in profitability and or net losses have been reported for the past two quarters by all telecom operators in the country without exception. A couple of operators have shut down their entire operations in the country. In this backdrop, our key financial and operational highlights for the quarter are consolidated revenue stood at ₹4,524 crores, down 8.1%, and EBITDA at ₹1,083 crores, down 10.2% compared to the trailing quarter in line with industry trends. The EBITDA margin declined to 24% compared to 24.5% in the trailing quarter. Financial highlights for the FY year, financial year 17 are consolidated revenue stood at ₹19,949 crore, down 10.8% year-on-year. The company suffered a net loss of ₹1,285 crore for the year compared to a net profit of ₹660 crore in the previous year. This is the first year since inception when ARCOM has incurred a net loss during the year, having shown steady financial and operational performance during last 10 years of its operation. ARCOM has been working steadfastly on execution of its well-planned, future-proof, all-round strategic transformation strategy since last 2 years. ARCOM, post-completion of transactions, would emerge as a strong player with solid operating businesses of high-margin domestic enterprise segment, data centers, optic fiber, and international business in GCX. Additionally, ARCOM will hold valuable strategic stakes of 50% in wireless JV and a 49% future economic upside in the tower business.
Okay. So, you know, the two points that you made right now, let's talk about that. What's the timeline that you're looking at, Gurdeep, to close the merger specifically? So, by when will the wireless business be demerged? And what's the timeline that you're looking at to merge the two companies? What's the broader timeline for both these two points?
Both the transactions are on track, and we are very confident of completing the transactions by 30th September this year.
So the demerger as well as the subsequent merger will be done by the 30th?
That's correct.
Okay. The other transaction that you've been mentioning is the Brookfield Tower deal. That's something that will bring in about 11,000 crore rupees. So can you confirm when will the full amount of 11,000 crore rupees come into the balance sheet for ARCOM?
We hope, we are very confident about consummation of the Brookfield Tower transaction by 30th September 2017, and immediately thereafter the proceeds will flow in.
So after 30th September is when the proceeds or the entire 11,000 crore rupees will come in?
So we expect the proceeds to come in by 30th September 2017 as the transaction gets consummated.
Okay, fine. Now, I want to understand your debt reduction plan, Gurdeep. You have made a statement yesterday in the con call saying that the payment and prepayment of 25,000 crore rupees from both these transactions will be made on or before September 2017. So 25,000 crore rupees, 11,000 crore of that is the amount that will be coming in from the Brookfield Tower transaction. Where is the 14,000 crore rupee cash coming in from that will enable you to make payments to your lenders?
It's a timing mismatch, but for unforeseen circumstances, both the transactions would have been consummated by now. Our lenders are very supportive and fully aligned, and mechanics are being worked out. We are confident of completing both the transactions by 30th September, which will bring our debt down by over 60%, that is rupees 25,000 crore. In fact, we will be making substantial amount of prepayments on the consummation of these transactions.
Okay. Firstly, since you mentioned the lender's point, have you approached the lenders already? What have the lenders and bondholders said? Because you have asked for deferment of loan repayments till the 30th of September, till you close these two transactions. So have all the lenders and bondholders come on board for this, Gurdeep?
Our lenders are very supportive and fully aligned, and mechanics are being worked out.
Okay.
Yeah.
There is a refinancing discussion also with the lenders. What's the update on that? When can we expect there to be some clarity on the refinancing agreement, and thereby, by how much can the interest costs come down?
Well, as I said just now, that we are confident of completing both the transactions by end September. Our lenders are very supportive and fully aligned. As we speak, the mechanics are being worked out. This will not only help us bring the debt down by 25,000 crore, that is over 60% from the current debt level, and in fact, we'll also be making a lot of prepayments on the consummation of these transactions.
Okay, since you mentioned prepayment, how much is due so far and how much is due till September, Gurdeep, if you can give us some clarity on that. And, you know, since you said that there is going to be more than the amount that is due, that's the amount that, you will be looking at paying. So what is the amount that is due so far and that will be due in September? If you can give us a breakup.
I just say that as the mechanics are being worked out, it's something that we'll come back and share with you later.
Okay, no problem. Gurdeep, the